And now we will learn how to create markups for reimbursable expenses. A markup is the extra amount you charge the client above your cost for the expenses that you put on an invoice as billable. You can set a default markup in the preferences window as a percent of the cost. You must choose an account to record the markup, and of course this is an income account because the extra amount above your cost is income to you. Don't worry, you can change the markup directly on the invoice at the moment that you bill the client for the reimbursable expenses. Let's change the default to a 25% markup and create an account called Profit from Reimbursable Expenses. From the main menu, click Edit, Preferences. Scroll all the way down to Time and Expense. Click Company Preference, and we will click Default Markup Percent. We will change from 0 to 25 and leave the percent symbol there. Now, the default markup account is the income account that the excess goes into. We have not created it yet, but we can create it now. Click the pull-down arrow and you get your entire chart of accounts. And instead of opening the chart of accounts window, we can just scroll all the way up, click Add New, and notice QuickBooks knows this is an income type of account. And we will type in profit from reimbursable expenses. Okay, click Save and Close. And now we have the account that we just created. You could go to the chart of accounts window in the list menu, or you could do it this way. As long as it's an income type of account, it doesn't really matter the name. Now click OK and congratulations, you're ready to charge extra to your customers for the billable expenses. To see if it works, we have to record a couple of billable expenses and then put them on an invoice. For example, let's record the March 12th check to Staples, check number 4, for supplies expense $100, billable to the Mockingbird Lane job. From the main menu, click Banking, write a check. QuickBooks remembers it's check number 4. Let's go forward to March 12th of 2017. Okay, I believe the vendor was Staples. Okay, don't worry that we have an open bill. Just click Continue Writing a Check. The money amount is $100. So we have supplies expense for $100. And then the job is the Mockingbird Lane job, and we'll mark it as billable. We'll click Save and Close, and we'll record the next expense. So let's record the next one, March 14th. Received bill number 8181 from Rex Repair for a repair job, billable to the Mockingbird Lane job, $300. From the main menu, click Vendor, Enter Bill. Now, this is March 14th. The bill number is 8181. It's for Rex Repair, repair expense. I believe the money amount was $300. And of course, this is the Mockingbird Lane job, and we have to check the billable box because we never switched the default back. When we click Save and Close, we can open the unbilled cost by job, and we can see now we have these two unbilled costs waiting to be put on an invoice, just like the previous video. Now, in a moment, we're going to put these expenses on an invoice, but please note, when we bill them, the expenses will become zero instead of being added to income. That's because we never set up income accounts for these expenses, even though we change the default in the preferences window. Now let's imagine on March 17, we billed Brown Company for an additional 10% of the Mockingbird Lane job. We will include all billable expenses. We open the invoice window, change the date to March 17th, choose the Mockingbird Lane job. Of course, here's the estimate, so we click on it, click OK. Just like in the earlier videos, we create an estimate, an invoice for 10% of the estimate. And when we click OK, we get the warning message that we have billable items for this job. Click OK, click Expenses. Now let's put both of these billable items on this same invoice. Click to select them in the left margin by placing the check mark. Notice the profit from reimbursed expenses is here as an income account, reminding us where it will go. Click OK, and if you scroll all the way down, notice what QuickBooks put. It put each individual expense, and you could type the description on the invoice if you want. This was supplies. You don't have to, but your client might want you to. And this is demolition. And then, of course, here's the total reimbursable expenses. And here's the markup. And here's the total that the client actually has to pay. In this case, $100 additional dollars over and above what we paid for these services. When we click Save and Close, When we click Save and Close, we can open the Profit and Loss by Job, and you can see, income from reimbursable expenses has shown up for the first time in this report for the Mockingbird Lane job, $100. In our second example, we will use the two expenses that we created income accounts for. So let's do the first one, March 20, pay check number 5 to Grecon for demolition, $200 for the Mockingbird Lane job. I'll be moving a little more quickly in this case. From the main menu, click Banking, write a check. Confirm that QuickBooks remembers its check number 5. The date we'll have to put forward to March 20. Now we'll choose Grecon as the vendor. And QuickBooks remembers this is demolition expense. The money amount is $200. The only additional step now is to put the Mockingbird Lane job and make the check mark here so that QuickBooks knows it's billable. Click Save and Close, and now let's enter the second one. March 22, received bill number 9191 from UPS for delivery. Billable to the Mockingbird Lane job. So, vendor, enter bill, March 22. The vendor is UPS. The expense is delivery. The bill is 9191 for $600. And of course, now we have to put the Mockingbird Lane job and mark it as billable. Save and close. Now, you should know that when we bill them, the expenses will stay and the amount paid to the vendor will be in their income accounts. We set up income accounts for these expenses after we change the default preference in the previous video. So because demolition and delivery have their own income accounts, and because we changed the preferences in the previous window, they will not be removed from the job costing report. They will simply be added to income, and additionally, 25% of that will be added to the profit from reimbursed expenses. Let's take a look at what happens. On March 25th, we billed the Brown Company for an additional 10% of the Mockingbird Lane job. We're going to include all billable expenses, but the markup will only be $250 by default, or $200 by default. we are going to change it to $300 at the moment that we make the invoice. We open the invoice window. The date is March 25th. The job is Mockingbird Lane. Of course, this is the estimate. Now we're doing an additional 10% just like we did in previous videos. We are going to select the outstanding billable time. And when we click here, we will choose both of these. Click in the left margin to place both of these billable expenses on the invoice. Click OK. Now when we scroll down, we can see that this was for the demolition and this was for the delivery. And the total markup is $200. It's nice to describe it on the invoice. Demolition, and this is for delivery. You don't have to, but it's nice to describe it for your client. Here's the total reimbursable expenses. Here's the $200 25% markup, which means $1,000 has been added to the invoice as a result. Now you have the physical ability to change the default markup from $200 to $300 at the moment that you record this invoice. Now when we click Save and Close, okay, this default keeps coming on, Save and Close, we open the profit and loss by job, and we can see profit from reimbursable expenses for the Mockingbird Lane job is $400. Notice the demolition and delivery stayed here in the Brown Company Mockingbird Lane job. And of course, they have been added to delivery fees and demolition fees for the Mockingbird Lane job. And only the excess amount was put into profit from reimbursable expenses. You can double click that profit right now and see it comes from two invoices. The previous invoice, the markup for the expenses was only $100. And in this invoice, March 22nd, the one that we just made, the profit from the reimbursable expenses on this particular invoice was $300, because that's what we changed it to at the moment we made the invoice.